everybody, I'm Kirsty Meeking from Naio Nails. In this video, we are going to do male nails.
This is the worst bit for me. This is like nails on a chalkboard.
Does this go through you?
Yeah.
I didn't expect,
because I don't normally file. Or as you can tell, my nail maintenance has been neglected for the last, 31 years.
Yeah.
It just makes my teeth tingle.
That's a weird sensation.
You know when you like shivers all through your body, you're like... Rrr.
So I'm going to do this on all of the nails. If I come across something that's really strange, I will point it out. You do want to slightly angle the file towards yourself.
So you're putting like a little lip on there?
Yeah, if you don't, if you keep it really flat,
yeah,
then you have this, these little bits of nails sort of sticking out. So this just gives it a more cleaner finish. What is that?
Oh, this. Sorry, I've got a double-jointed thumb.
Did he get this? This is just disgusting.
Sorry, I just thought you wanted it to have it up nice for you, so I just thought I'd pop it down.
What? That's not normal.
It's just double-jointed.
Did you not break it or something?
No.
What's the matter?
So I was trying to file his nail, and look what he did. I was like, what?
I don't get it.
It's just that there's two.
Can you do that? Because yeah. I most certainly can't. This bit. How can you?
That bit. Just
bend that bit back.
That.
No. That.
All right. All right.
Yeah, that's a bit weird. I was filing it and I just looked and went, "What?"
You just pushed it further back than it should really go.
Yeah, I was like, "Hey."
It's like an accordion.
It's like a broken train in hand.
Oh, stop it! It's horrible!
You pull it to where you want it.
It just doesn't look right. So I'm using a 240 grit file because I'm filing a natural nail. I don't want to go in with this, 100 grit file. No.
That looks like grip tape from skateboarding.
It does, doesn't it?
Feels like it too.
It does. See, if you're short of a nail file, you could.
I've always got my skateboard.
You've always got your skateboard. It's like a huge nail file.
Don't tell my missus that because I'll never get it back. So should you clean the nails out first and then file them?
Yeah, because you want to get rid of the dirt first of all. But when you're filing, you will get debris underneath. So you can see here, you'll get bits of nail filings under there. So you can give it a wipe, but you can also just have a little scoop underneath.
Oh, wow.
That is
really gross close up, isn't it? Wow, I thought I'd get more followers from doing this, not more people being like, his nails are minging. Have you seen how gross that guy is?
What's your funniest joke?
Oh!
Wow, right.
I went there.
Should my agent have not said something about that? That's good. I have a lot of different favourite jokes, none of which are mine, so I can't tell them on camera, unfortunately, because I don't want to get sued by any other comics.
Really?
No, that was a joke. That was just calm down. Calm down.
Hold on.
You put me on the spot.
Yeah.
I love my opening joke.
Go on then. Again, tell us.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Matthew Fong, and I'm half Chinese, but don't worry, ladies, it's the top half. So, that just gets people on a nice even
just
level.
Breaks the
I
ice.
Like to set the bar quite low, usually around waist height or just under. It depends where you measure it from.
What I am going to do with this file is just exfoliate.
Oh wow!
The very tip of these fingers here. just to smooth that callus a little bit.
I didn't realise how nice rubbing the tip could be. That is, that feels genuinely pleasurable.
Is it nice?
Yeah, yeah. It's really good.
You like it?
Yes. Do more.
I'm going to do more. So, you can see that that's a lot smoother, but you've still got... Now, don't get me wrong, this callus needs to be there, because it protects when you're doing your...
Wow, mine's more like blong 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 blong.
All right. What, are you a bass guitarist?
No. Just really bad. Just really bad.
Yeah, so I'm just going to do this on your fingers just to smooth them. You've got to do this with a smooth file. Don't be tempted to just use a really coarse file because you'll leave it quite uneven, basically, and it'll... You run the risk of filing too much away. You don't want to file it all away because you need a little bit of that callus there to protect your fingers.
I'm surprised you don't need glasses when you're working on such small
bits. I think that day will come.
I've said that before, like, you know, like a jeweller who has the chink, chink, chink so they can zoom in.
That noise, that you can't say that when I'm in the room.
Oh, no. Right, what I'm going to do now is wipe over with the gel residue wipe-off solution. And this is going to remove the oil from the nail plate. Because I'm going to buff this natural nail. And I don't want the oil from the nails to go on the buffer either. Now, this is a white block. It has sharp sides. You need to get rid of that. So, do you like this sound? Is this nice for you? It's good? Yeah, you're good with this? So, what I'm going to do is go across the nail.
Oh, that's worse than the file.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Serious?
Yeah.
Your teeth on edge?
No, I've got cold legs now. I don't know what it is. You're just sending me weak at the knees.
So, I'm removing the surface shine. This is the easiest way to do this with a white block. You could use your 240 grit file. If you prefer.
Oh no, the block's better. The block's better.
You like the block?
Yeah, that's better.
Is that less...
That's less...
mentally painful?
Yeah, yeah. I feel this one still, but that one was like, ooh, tingles.
Yeah, not good.
Yeah. See, guys definitely don't appreciate how much effort goes into getting the nails looking nice and being all buff.
They do like a good buffing, though, now and then, don't they? Should always have a bit of buffing now and then. You do need to pull back the skin as well. So you can see that I'm holding it quite tight and I'm pulling back the skin so I can get right to those side walls. I'm going to wipe over again with the gel residue wipe-off solution. Clean them up, ready for the gel polish. Now, this is a male manicure, so we aren't going to add... I know people are going to be thinking, oh, my God, what's it going to have fluorescent pink? This is a male manicure, so we are keeping everything very natural. This is for somebody who likes to keep their nails in tip-top condition and wants them to look nice and clean. So, like, I think this would be perfect for a businessman.
Yeah, so I could go into a board meeting and be like, hi, look at my nails. I'm obviously in the wrong room.
I think that if you've got clean shoes and clean nails that are, you know, well looked after, then...
I do like shoes. Not as much as my girlfriend, though. She has a bigger habit than I have.
Yeah. So we've got base coat. This is the Urban Graffiti base coat. Now, we see this here. This is a lamp.
Right, okay.
And your hand's going to go in there. As you put your hand in there, I don't want you to, like, go and knock it all. I want you to put it in there very nice and...
Be gentle.
And gentle and careful. Just like that.
Just slip it in.
Just slip it in. Nice and... Okay. So we are going to do this hand first, yeah?
Right, okay.
So this base coat will grab to the nail. You want it to be nice and neat. See, now if we'd left all of that non-living tissue on the nail plate, it would interfere with the base coat and it would lift it off. It's very important to keep that nail plate nice and clean. You only need a thin layer. So how long have you skated for?
Started skateboarding when I was about 13, like doing it every day.
Mm-hmm.
And then just, it's really addictive, I think, extreme sports. If you've got that kind of mindset where you've just got to keep going until you land that trick.
Yeah.
And obviously skateboarding's good if you've not got very many friends as well, so just go out and do it on your own.
Pop me that in the lamp for me.
Slip it in.
Can you get it in?
Oh, my thumb's not gonna.
Oh, maybe we'll have to do your thumb separate. Big hand problems. So yeah, I'm gonna do these four fingers. I'm gonna learn from that.
What about you? Inline, is that right?
Yeah, so I started skating when I was little, you know, like most people did when I was little. Everybody had a pair of skates. Then I started skating, then I got into inline, I skated quads, then I skated inline. I had like a 15-year break.
15 years of no skating?
No skating.
What was that?
That was, I think, called children and boys.
Children and boys, yeah.
Is it not boys first, then children?
Well, that's usually how it works, I think.
I mean, my brother skated, my brother's mate skated, I'll tell you something about me. I actually got married when I was 18.
Oh.
To a skateboarder.
Like a sponsored skateboarder?
No, but he's very good.
All right.
Bit of an idiot, though. Do you want to pop that in the lamp?
Yeah, no worries.
Are we leaving that in?
Yeah. And I'll do the thumb after.
That's the thing with skateboarders. Like you.
I loved him. I was in awe of him because he was such a good skateboarder.
But an awful person.
But he was lovely. He just turned into a not a very nice person. So, yeah, his sort of lifestyle changed, and I put him in a bin bag and got rid of him. No. I don't mean literally. It's just, you know, he is alive still somewhere.
Unfortunately.
Yeah, with less, with try and find the body.
You know, I'm not saying he's not a nice guy because I've seen him since, you know, we are friends. So skateboarding and skating was always in my youth.
It's a really good scene because I think if you go around to the skate park, and I know that you know, some of the Grey Brigade think that skate parks are antisocial and it causes gangs and stuff like that, but it was always a good sense of family.
Definitely.
And it didn't really matter whether you were on BMX, inline skates or skateboards, mm-hmm. just as long as you weren't on a micro scooter.
As long as you're not on a scooter, then you're good, and as long as you're not snaking anybody, then it's fine. We'll accept.
Yeah. You know, or if you do snake somebody, you better be good.
Yeah. All forms of wheels are allowed as long as you're not snaking people, or on a scooter. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I will always wear my wrist guards. I always wear a lid in a skate park as well.
Your book, isn't it?
Yeah, I can't mess.
Have you insured those bad boys like a surgeon?
I haven't, but people are telling me I need to.
Yeah. So right, you insure them, I'll stamp on them, we'll split it.
Okay. Maybe we need to cut that bit out. Right, so I'm going to use the matte top coat now.
Just named after me.
Of course, yeah. Straight on top of that base coat. Make sure you cover the entire nail. And I know you're working clear on clear, so it is difficult to see. Just make sure you get a nice, even coat on the nail. I'm going to do that on all of the nails.
So how long will this last in the in a real world situation?
In the real world situation, you're talking 2 weeks.
That's good.
But because you're a skateboarder, maybe less.
Yeah.
And is that just because of the growth?
It's just the growth, yeah. It's not that it's going to chip away and that. It'll just sort of grow out and need redoing. But this will, it'll grow out. Pop that in the lamp. And I'm going to get you put both thumbs in the lamp together. I've already painted that one, but I want you to just make sure that they have a full cure.
A full cure?
Mm.
Is that the technical?
Yeah.
Yeah, you are curing.
You're curing the
nail. Well, the gel polish.
Yeah, so this isn't going to air dry. This is being cured in the lamp.
This is 21st century, isn't it? It is like being on Star Trek.
Right, so as you look at these, they still have a little bit of shine on them, so we're going to wipe over them to remove the sticky layer, because if you feel that.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Like an already
inhibition layer.
Already sticky label.
So we wipe the sticky layer off. And there you have a matte nail.
Wow.
So it looks a little bit more manly.
It's Hollywood that, isn't it?
Matly.
Matly
or manly. This is the only thing I don't like about natural nails. They get dirty so easy. And what I'm going to do is finish these off with a little bit of cuticle oil. So I think pink pineapple is a perfect one for you. Because you've been talking about pineapples.
Oh, yeah. It's a good callback.
We're going to rub this in. So just nourish the skin.
And your tongue won't swell up.
Yeah.
Yep. God, I need, it's a two-thumb. It's a two-thumb job.
I've had my hands held. I've not slept with a person, so.
Oh, duck.
Count yourself lucky is what I'm trying to say.
Right, let's have a little look at these. Now, they look loads better. Now, you can see that they're actually quite flush with pinkness. Mm. Pink colour. Yeah. Because we've been rubbing them and massaging them and the blood is flowing into the fingers. And that will mean that the nails will grow quicker as well. Mm. The more blood flowing, the more cells that grow in the matrix. Sorry, I'm getting a bit technical.
All right.
But yeah, look at them.
I know,
they
are
beautiful. Didn't know you could be a hand model, did you?
No, I had no idea.
Just think, when you've got your hand around your mic now, it's just going to look so much better.
Well, it's good because I get to see that part of my hand anyway, so it's a benefit for me more than anyone else.
Same for the other reason as well, yeah.
I thought I was supposed to be the one bringing jokes. You know, why invite me on if you've got somebody who's incredibly funny and talented, you know?
So where can people find you? Because you're such a funny man.
Oh, thank you very much. Well, you can get me on Facebook, mm-hmm. which is Matthew Fong Comedian. Mm-hmm. Instagram, Matthew Fong Comedian. And on Twitter, Matt Fong Comic. Because somebody already took Matt Fong Comedian.
Oh, how rude.
I know. I'm going to hunt them down. But like yeah. I say, there's a lot of fongs to go through.
A lot of fongs.
Yeah.
A lot of fongs.
A lot of fongs. The phone book.
There's a lot of fongs in the phone book, yeah. Which is a nice bit of alliteration there as well. I'd say that three times fast. Too many fongs in the phone book.
Too many fongs. I like it. So I'm sure Adam will link everything in the description box. So yeah, I am really pleased with them. Are you pleased with them?
I am absolutely made up. Yeah, these are wicked. Thanks very much.
Yeah. So there you are, guys. Hope you enjoyed that video. When I say guys, I mean guys, because Luke, oh my God, we have a guy on camera. It's amazing. Yet I'm still single. So anyway, don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel, because we have 1.1 million subscribers, and that's down to you subscribing. So please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. And you might even see Matt. Keep watching.
See ya. Bye.